In this video, I am going to discuss D-block elements, part 2. In part 1, I have uploaded introduction part and some properties we have discussed, right? So, in this video, part 2, I am going to discuss remaining properties, short revision, and some questions also we can discuss what they are asking frequently in final examination. Okay, now first one, now in previous video I had given non-transition elements. Non-transition elements are non-transition elements I have given list, and just to see definition first, non-transition elements, zinc, cadmium, mercury. So these elements we call it as first B group or 12th group. 12th group. Okay. So transition is nothing but in between. Its properties belong to both and S P block elements. Okay. S block elements more metal. D block elements and F block elements also metal. P block elements, most of the elements are non-metals and metalloids also we have. D block elements metallic nature belongs to both S and P. That's the reason. And compared to S, it is less metallic nature. When compared to P, it is more metallic nature. So that is the olden definition. But what is the new definition? What is the definition of non-transition elements? Elements which is having completely filled electronic configuration, completely filled EC, electronic configuration, in its ground state or any one of its common oxidation state. Its common oxidation state. Clear? Like example, Zn. Zn, what is the outermost electronic configuration? Electronic configuration videos also have uploaded, students. Watch it, definitely you will get good idea how to write. So 30 atomic number, argon and 4s2 common for all D block elements, 3D series. So 3D, here 0, here also 10. That's it, students. That's it. Now this is completely filled. S is capacity 2 electrons, completely filled. D capacity 10 electrons, that is also completely filled. And next, what I said, it's common oxidation state. Zn shows plus 2 oxidation state. Plus 2 means where we have to remove electron, here. So last shell we have to remove electron. Highest principal quantum number. Right? See, this is also completely filled. In both the cases, completely filled in its ground state or any one of the common oxidation state. So those elements we call it as non-transition elements. Non-transition elements. I will tell you one more point here. It exhibits pseudo-inert gas configuration. Pseudo-inert gas configuration. Generally, pseudo-inert gas configuration species having more covalent nature. I'm writing here points. Covalent and ionic character questions, very common in inorganic chemistry. So I have uploaded chemical bonding part. In that part, I have given shortcut, short revision. So anyone missed the first year chemical bonding chapter, you can watch it. And definitely will get idea. Chemical bonding who are very strong, definitely they feel very comfortable in inorganic chemistry. Pseudo inert gas configuration, more covalent. More covalent, less ionic. Students, I am giving one more point. Pseudo inert gas is nothing but 18 electrons in the valency shell. 18 electrons in the valency shell. That's it, students. How we can check it? Now, if you write expanded form, if you write the overall electronic configuration, you will get a good idea. See, Zn. Zn plus 2. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2 gone, students, 4s2 gone, yes or no? So here simple, Zn, he is telling to us, I have lost 2 electrons. Who is giving electrons? Who is lost electrons? So he is plus oxidation state, right? So So how many electrons Jordan lost? Yes, he lost 2 electrons. Then where did he lost 4s? Above case I have shown. Now see students, this is outermost shell. If you write shell wise representation, this is the first shell, second shell, third shell, three shells. See, so 3s2, 3p6, 3d10. See how many electrons students? 18 electrons, which is having 18 electrons in the outermost shell, that we call it as pseudo inert gas configuration. Pseudo inert gas configuration. If it is there, definitely it shows more covalent character. You will get question like this. Based on this good concept I had given chemical bonding video, you can see, you will get more idea. Calcium chloride, Zn chloride, which is more covalent? Zn chloride, more covalent. Just now I have showed why it has inert gas or pseudo inert gas. It has pseudo inert gas. That's it. Here, after lost 2 electrons, it is reaching, it reaches the inert gas configuration. Inert gas, argon state it is. Okay, that's why he is more ionic means least covalent, right? So you can expect questions like this. 4 different ways they are framing questions: covalent, more ionic, least ionic. Now next important one, I am writing some points students. First one is paramagnetic. Transition element shows paramagnetic in nature. And the next one, this is fourth one, right? And the fifth one, showing magnetic movement. Next, sixth one, color. Seventh one, strong intermetallic bonding. Next, eighth one, more melting points. See, fourth question to eighth question, what is the reason? Due to the presence of, only one answer student. Due to the presence of unpaired electrons. Paramagnetic means unpaired electrons. Showing magnetic movement also unpaired electrons. But I am writing one additional point also here. Okay, unpaired electrons, I will write one more point. 2 points minimum required, I am writing additional point here. Showing magnetic movement means what is the reason? Definitely reason is unpaired electron, that's it. And additional is what happened? N increases, I said yesterday, N increases, U also increases. N increases, U also increases. What is N? Unpaired electrons, U is nothing but magnetic moment. Magnetic moment, how to calculate, what is the shortcut? We used previous video, please watch it. Color, yes. Color also, what is the reason? Unpaired electron. Along with unpaired electron, it has one more point. Inner DD transition. Inner DD transition. What is that? I can show. So, but main reason is unpaired electrons only. But in intermetallic bonding, yes, it is also reason unpaired electrons. More melting points, that is also reason unpaired electrons. See, for all the cases, if you add one more point, you can add here. So, a strong intermetallic, more unpaired electrons is there. Yes, more bonding. More unpaired electrons, definitely strong bonding. Strong bonding. If it is strong bonding, students, definitely we need to break. Enthalpy of atomization also high. And next one, more melting points. More melting points. And enthalpy of atomization, that is also very high. What is the reason? Because of unpaired electrons. See, you can study like this, enthalpy of atomization. If you study like this before examination, it is very easy, comfortable. Suppose some of the students, they were facing theory examination. So within half an hour, you can complete the chapter. After that, KMNO4, K2, CR2, 7 preparations and its properties also there, how to study. So coming days, I'm going to upload oxidizing agent, reducing agent, and balancing the reactions also I'm going to explain to you. Okay. Now, next one. Next point. So I had given reason, right? So here I'm giving explanation. See, explanation, suppose color. Let me discuss about color. Color, one of the important question. Fe shows generally plus 2 oxidation state, plus 3. And ion plus 1 also there, it is in brown ring. That is exceptional case we have to remember. In brown ring only ion shows plus 1 oxidation state. That is exceptional case. Exceptional cases plays important role for exam. Plus 2, plus 3. It is in green color and it is in brown color. Okay. So why it is showing color? See students, unpaired electrons. Unpaired electrons. Fe. Fe plus 2. So means 4s2, 3d6. Right? So outermost argon, this is the common for all the cases. Gone here electrons. Fe plus 2. Argon, right? And 3d6. 3d6 means if you write box method students, how many unpaired electrons? Yesterday, previous class we have completed, no? So this is 5, 6. This is n equal to 4. N equal to 4. N equal to 4 means magnetic moment is same value, 4.8 volt magneton, because of this unpaired electrons. Unpaired electrons are here active. So let me write points. Unpaired electrons are actively participating. Paired means already in stable state, no, he cannot excite. He don't excite. If excitation is not there, it doesn't show color. So unpaired electrons are participate in bond formation. Participate in bond formation. That is why. So that is strong metallic bonding, more unpaired electrons, more bonding. Okay, strong metallic bonding. Next one, what is this? More MPs, more melting points. And next one more. I'm covering so many points with less time I'm writing. Color, what is this color students? Yes, excitation. Unpaired electrons only excite. Suppose how it is excite, I can show actually. Briefly, I am explaining here. Coordination chemistry chapter, next videos I can upload. There we can discuss the more points. It's split into two parts. So whenever ligands approaching, whenever ligands is nothing but electron donors approaching, first it will go to the excited state, further split into two levels. Out of three, two is one set, three is one set. Three is one set, two is one set, like this. It can split. This is triplet. This is, we call it as doublet. Detailed explanation coming days we can see. Suppose unpaired electron is there. Whenever it absorbs energy, it will go to the higher state. Higher state, again unstable, come back to the lower state. Excitation means absorbing energy. De-excitation means releasing energy. Releasing energy, if you send into any analyzer like prism, it shows color. So that is the reason for showing color. Ion. And on simple color wheel also I am writing here. Suppose it absorbed red color, it shows green color. It absorbed blue color, orange. Yellow, violet. These colors mainly we are seeing. Okay, color wheel. Next, suppose it absorbed blue, it shows complementary color is orange. It is green absorbed, red it shows like that. Okay, finally, unpaired electrons are reason. Okay, suppose next one more question. Fe plus 3, another color, Fe plus 2, different unpaired electrons, depends on unpaired electrons. Next one, Cu plus 1, Cu plus 2. Cu plus 1, Cu plus 2. Cu plus 1 is colorless. Cu plus 2 is colored. Reason. What is the reason? What is the reason? See students, copper. Copper 29, it is anomalous configuration. Anomalous configuration, one electron jumps. So this is, I am writing. I said already, what is this? Electronic configuration videos I have uploaded. Please watch it if you have any doubts. So see, Cu plus 1. Cu plus means after loss electron here. This is what? 3d10, right? Cu+2. Cu+2 means where we are removing electron? Here. It's very difficult. It's very difficult. In previous video also had given, ionization energy is very high, very high, because stable electronic configuration removing. After a great difficulty we removed electron, then what happened here, students? 3d, 3d, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. See, unpaired electron, one unpaired electron. At least one unpaired electron also, it can show color. So that's why Cu+1 is colorless, Cu+2 is colored. That is blue color, blue, royal blue color. Okay, Cu(SO4)5H2O, copper pentahydrate, copper sulfate pentahydrate, royal blue color. We have studied, no, blue vitriol. Why? What is the reason? Finally, unpaired electron. Even we are seeing rainbow also. Nowadays, we are seeing more rainbow. What is the reason? Their water droplet acts as a analyzer, and through water droplet, suppose sun rays are passing, that is analyzer like, sun rays are passing. So the output is seems to be colors, that is rainbow we are observing. Okay. So with the maximum properties we covered, students. Now next one more is there. Next, another property, 10th property, colorless, and 12th one is, and above cases do not show magnetic moment. Above properties just opposite, do not show magnetic moment. And less boiling point, less melting point, like this. Colorless and do not show magnetic moment is nothing but absence of unpaired electrons. Okay, these two questions that is suitable for this answer, absence of unpaired electrons, else you can write one more point, paired electron. If it is paired, the given box is suppose like this, students, this is paired, okay, this is unpaired. This is third one, what is this? Diamagnetic. Most important one is diamagnetic. It is weakly repelled by applied magnetic field. Applied field, electromagnetic field and electric field. Okay, and paramagnetic is nothing but weakly attracted. But ferromagnetic substances is nothing but strongly attracted. Strongly attracted. See, so many points we have covered, students. Paramagnetic. So this is what? Weakly attracted. Weakly attracted by applied field. That's it, students. Clear? So like this you can write. So now suppose they asked a question. Why transition metal shows color? Due to the presence of unpaired electrons and inner d-d transitions. That's it. Why magnetic moment is high? Due to the presence of unpaired electrons. In other case also unpaired electrons, no, how? If more unpaired electrons, more magnetic moment. That's the reason finally, who is the guy? Unpaired electron only, right? So like that, you have to connect the questions. Then questions will be more, answers will be less, you feel. Then your studying time also feels very comfortable. With less time, we can cover more points. Reasoning type questions you can expect in board examination plus whatever you are writing, set exams and writing whatever it is, mains and NEET. There is no too much difference between mains and NEET inorganic chemistry. But organic chemistry, lot of difference is there. Inorganic chemistry, if you thoroughly prepare, so textbooks definitely will get very good marks. Now, next one, catalyst. Why transition metals act as catalyst? This is one of the questions. Transition metal acts as catalyst. Why? Reason. First one. Okay, first one, example. In Haber's process. What is Haber's process? N2+3H2 gives rise to 2NH3. It is in gaseous state. It is also in gaseous state. Ion is the catalyst. See, molybdenum is promoter. Next one, Ostwald's process. All familiar process. industrial process, Ostwald's process. This is preparation of what is this? Nitric oxide. That is nitric acid. Nitric oxide first step, and you have to balance the reaction also. Okay, so this is also we are using platinum gauze, 500 Kelvin temperature, 9 bar pressure. We are maintaining on this thing, right? Here also what we observed, platinum and the lead chamber process, contact process. Lead chamber process, nitric oxide, but contact process. Contact process, what we used, contact process. Contact process means preparation of sulfuric acid, right? So this is surface chemistry also, homogeneous catalysis, heterogeneous catalysis, they are asking questions. Here what I am trying to say, contact process. Yes, in contact process also, students, so we are preparing, what is this? Sulfuric acid. In contact process also, what is this main one? Okay, one second. Directly we are not preparing sulfuric acid. First we are preparing oleum, students. The oleum, after that wash with water, then we are preparing sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid here we are not preparing directly because it is highly explosive, and whatever you are preparing sulfuric acid in contact process, it is in fog state, that is vapor state. With vapor state further conversion into liquid, it's very dangerous, highly exothermic reaction. According to Lee Chartier's principle, we have to see the favorable conditions also. So coming videos I can upload. So then what is this? Vanadium pentoxide. Here all catalyst, all transition metals only access catalyst. What is the reason? Reason it provides good surface area. In surface chemistry also we have studied. Suppose the catalyst is like this surface. Okay, the catalyst is like this surface. So which is the more favorable? Definitely this one. Suppose you are sending gaseous molecules, gases. So here also gaseous molecules, adsorption takes place, no, AD, adsorption. So here less molecules, because availability of molecules is more. Most of the gaseous molecules are want to participate in the reaction, but space is not much. But if you look into the another one, here more surface area, right? So see, more surface area, definitely here what happened, more adsorption takes place. So finally what happened, according to chemical kinetics we have studied, catalyst decreases activation energy. This is according to kinetics we are speaking, but here it provides good surface area. If more surface area, most of the reactant molecules participate in the reaction, reaction will complete soon, right? So next reason, due to availability of d orbitals, if availability of d orbitals is there, then what happens, students? Expansion possible. So that is why this is one of the common question in inorganic chemistry. Let me write here, second period elements. So like let me complete second period elements. What are second period elements? Common question this is. Not only d block elements, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, right? Lithium, beryllium, boron, next one, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. See here, these are all second period elements do not have d orbitals. That is why, what is the reason? Suppose one question I am explaining, example, nitrogen maximum covalency is 4. So 5 not possible. 5 covalency not possible. 5 valency possible. 5 valency possible. So beyond that it is not 5 covalency. Not valency, no, valency possible. 5 covalency not possible. Reason, what is the reason, students? lack of d orbital. Lack of d orbitals, not only nitrogen, all elements it will be the same thing. Nitrogen, one of the common question, that's why I have taken this one. Right, oxygen also, what is the maximum covalency, why not other cases, carbon also, carbon hydrolysis is not possible, silicon it is possible, why, what is the reason? Unavailability of d orbitals. Here, expansion, so it is the 3D, d block elements means d orbitals available, 3D, 3D, 3D available, so it is one electron or two electron, that is not matter, expansion it is possible, excited state, suppose the first T we are taking, suppose if you take phosphorus, nitrogen I have taken a phosphorus, I can show 3s2 3p5, this is ground state, right? 3d is there, but it is zero, availability is there. So after that, if you take excited state box method, you can write your two electrons, your students, your how many electrons, 1 2 3 4 5, so then what happened, this is ground state, you can write ground state zero. So now here paired electron jumps here. Excited state is nothing but paired electron jumps here. Systematically it can go, which is paired first to 3p. It will go after that 3d like this. Clear? That's all. Excited state possible. See. Now 1, 2. This as it is, you can write here 1, 2. Here one electron. Here one electron. Here one electron. This electron jumps here. No. Clear my point, students? Okay, so let it more clearly. Here two electrons, one electron. Here all two electrons. Two, one. That's it. Now, how many unpaired electrons? Three unpaired electrons means PCl3. If you will take next excited state, next PCl5 formation takes place like this. FeCl2, FeCl3, like this expansion it is possible. Expansion means structure it is increasing, size increasing means surface area increasing. It is good catalyst, right? And next one, complexes. Variable oxidation state it can show means availability of d orbitals. Variable valency, more than one oxidation state, that is phosphorus 3, 5, and ion also, ion ferrous 2+3 and copper +1+2 and mercury also +1+2. Why? Showing due to availability of d orbitals. Reason, and another reason, less energy gap ns2 electrons and n-1d, outermost is 4s2 3d. If you want to remove this electron 4s2, because of less energy gap this electron also coming out, same thing. So that's the reason it shows more than one valency, few elements. Okay, now next one. Last one, complexes. So due to small size and availability of d orbitals. That's it. Okay, as we move across the period, what happens? Size decreases. Clear, students? Size decreases. That's why, right. So transition elements, because of small size, it forms the complexes. K4, Fe, CN6, ion. And K3, Fe, CN6, complex. Next lessons, you are going to learn this one. And a nickel also, nickel cyanides, nickel chlorides, cobalt complexes, complex this time also, it can show. So the transition elements only. And last one more point, that is interfacial compounds. Interfacial compounds, in coming videos I am going to upload, students, it will be more lengthy. Interfacial compounds and next properties and next coming videos I can upload. Thank you, students. Thanks for watching. And inorganic chemistry, many reactions we have. But how to study in simple way? Coming days I am going to do. Subscribe all our channel and encourage. And please watch all the points. students, if you have any confusion, electronic configuration, also watch those videos and get benefit. So thank you, students. Thanks for watching.